And all right, friends, hope you're ready. We may not be crisscrossed. We're about to make you jump, jump. This is Jumpin' Flash with Joester 98. Take it away.
All right. Hello again, everyone. I am Joester 98. I ran Pac-Man arrangement yesterday. Back again. Hopefully you caught that run. It was pretty cool. With me, I have Kane, a proud member of the PlayStation Nation. This is Jumping Flash. So this game originally came out in 1995. I know the title screen says 96, but this is a different release of the game. This is actually the first 3D platformer that was ever made. So all your favorite 3D games come back to this game. And so with that, let's get started in 3, 2, 1, go. Here we go. Now to screw up the very first jump in the game.
Ready to go?
All right, I didn't do it. I didn't screw it up. We're all set. The run can continue. So the goal in each level in this game is there's 4 jet pods in each level, so I have to get those and then just get to the exit platform. The jet pods look exactly like carrots, so I'm just going to call them carrots because that's a way better term. Your main character in this is a robotic rabbit named Robbit, fittingly, and there he is. So, that was the first stage, extremely quick. Most of the levels in this game are pretty quick.
It's a pretty chill game.
Yeah. With some really banging music. We'll get some really good tunes later as well. So how the jumping in this game works, obviously it's pretty central to the game, it's in the title, is you get a triple jump, so you get one jump off the ground and then 2 jumps in the air. And when you jump in the air, the camera will automatically pan down so you can see where you're going to land. It's a neat little mechanic so you can figure out where you're supposed to go.
All right.
And at the end of that level, I picked up a bomb. So you want to pick up weapons for the bosses in this game because the bosses take a while to kill without them, and the weapons in this game, pretty much all of them are really overpowered. So now I have 2 bombs for this first boss here. This first boss is the just this dragon. This guy will die pretty quickly.
The other important boss strat is bouncing on them because bouncing does a lot more damage than just shooting them.
Oh, we almost set the first boss down. 15?
All right.
16. One note is this game on leaderboards uses in-game time because this bonus screen here takes longer if you get a faster time. So in some levels, it would be faster in real time to sit next to the end of level portal and then jump on it. And that's obviously really dumb. So we use in-game time. And speaking of in-game time, there's a neat strat I'm going to do here. I'm just going to pause and try again, which loses a life. But if you do that with no weapons, the game will give you a bomb. So if you notice, I have a bomb now on the left side of the screen there. And that's important because this world is really dry of weapons. So I need that bomb for the next boss, because otherwise it would take a lot longer. Nice. It's a pretty small platform you have to land on there.
Yeah, pretty much every object you can land on and jump off of, no matter how small it is in this game.
Yeah. So you may see some like awkward movement, and that's because this game has tank controls, because it came out before analog sticks were even a thing. So the movement might look a little awkward, but that's just because of the controls. That is 49 is the best time you can get on that stage, so that was really, really good. And I picked up a Roman candle at the end there. The Roman candle is probably the best weapon in the game. And you'll see that on this boss. Now we have a bit of a change. This is like a dungeon level, which is odd for a 3D game. So it's pretty tight. Corridors, a lot of enemies. Just really kind of emphasizes your movement in here.
Yeah, despite being a 3D platformer, they decided to go with a 2D level design for some reason.
As the first 3D platformer, we're going to put a 2D level in our game for no reason. All right, where's this guy? That's a good position. That guy can get in your way and really wreck your day.
Yeah, these sand bars are pretty annoying. You have to jump over them or it's really slow. And you can't jump backwards over them, even though there's the physical space to, just because they don't let you.
Alright, next boss. This boss is going to be a little different from the first in that he actually has multiple phases. And in this game, the bosses, when they're switching between phases, you can't damage them. So I'm going to try and set up to land on them right as the phase switches to the second one. Alright, here's the Roman Candle. There we go, that was really good. That was a really good boss fight. This might be a 19.
Almost.
That's really good. It's a really good time on that boss. All right, so far, so good. So do you want to maybe try and explain the plot of this game? Because there kind of is one.
If I'm not mistaken, the plot is that some rich guy decided to abduct chunks of the Earth in order to put them in his vacation resort in space. But it's been a while, and I've largely only played on the J version, so...
Yeah, this is actually the Japanese-English version. So this game first came out in Japan, and that version is not good. The jumping is really just... it doesn't work as well. And then it came out in the US, and then they realized, oh, the English version is way better. And so when they released Jumping Flash 2 in Japan, they re-released it with Jumping Flash 1. They released the English version, but they region-locked it for Japan. So that's the version that I'm playing here, is the English version, but it's Japanese region-locked. So I restarted again at the beginning of this level to get another bomb. Bomb is extremely good for the next boss, mostly because it has the best spread of any of the weapons, and that will be very, very important because without it, the next boss is like impossible to do even remotely quickly. All right, there's a cycle at the start of this level I want to catch. Nice.
Nice. That's actually really hard to get.
It's pretty tight. Jumping on that balloon, there's a couple really small platforms you have to land on. So now we're going to toilet the frame right here by having the whole level on screen. This game is basically just a tech demo for the PS1, just to showcase what it was capable of. So there are some spots in this game where it'll run at like 20 FPS there, and there are some spots where it's a crisp 60. And it bounces all over the place, which can be a little frustrating.
All right.
That was a really good level. 38 is the best you can get there.
Nice.
Now for this boss. So this boss, there's a bunch of teacups that parts of the boss pop up out of randomly. And you have to beat every single one. So let's just hope we get some good luck here.
Ready to go?
Oh, I got an extra weapon. That's really good.
Oh, you got a Roman candle, too.
Kill this, maybe? Well, that's good. Maybe something pop out of here?
Yeah.
Oh, this is really good. That was extremely
very nice.
Good. All right, yeah, the best ever there is a 32, and I got a 33 in a marathon. That's insanely good. Yeah, normally that, if you get, I got a bunch of extra weapon drops on that, which getting extra weapons is random. And I got good weapons too, so I just obliterated that boss. Sometime, through no fault of your own, you can just lose 15 seconds on that boss due to just not getting lucky. That was really, really good though.
Ready to go?
This is an ice level. The ice physics aren't really going to apply just because you're in the air most of the time. This is one of my favorite levels in the game. It's really cool. No pun intended.
Plus, the music has a nice bass line.
Oh, yeah.
This jump here to the final platform off this house is kind of tight.
All right.
Perfect. 36 is the best you can get on that level, so another really good level. This has been a pretty good run so far, actually. I might be ahead of record, but I don't know because I'm not timing it. During the week, I've been just using the calculator on my phone to time my runs.
All right, so we got another dungeon crawler up next.
Yeah, this one is much more obnoxious than the first because of this enemy here. All this enemy does is get in your way and slow you down. He does literally nothing else. So this is probably a good time for donations. Otherwise, I'm just going to spend the entire time complaining about those guys. So go away. Go ahead.
You got it. I have $25 from Cyberbot X. I'm so happy to see jumping flashed into a GDQ again after my run at SGDQ 2012. I just wish I could be there in person to see the run. Show that Baron Aloha who's boss, Joester. Also, we need more Untitled Goose Game. Honk. And $25 from the Lone Orchid. Shoutouts to that extremely dated Crisscross reference. Jumping Flash was the first ever PlayStation game I've played. I had no idea how to play the game at 7, but it inspired my love for PlayStation gaming. I remember going to my friend's house after school to play Jumping Flash, Road Rash, and X Games. Good luck on the run.
Thank you. So that enemy luck was actually, like, exceptionally good in that level. If those guys are floating in the middle of the path, it's extremely difficult to get around them, and it's also extremely slow to kill them, so there's just no winning strategy there. 54 is the best you can get there, too. I've had, like, 5 or 6 levels that have been, like, the best time you can possibly get in this run already. All right, now we have another boss. So this boss, I'm going to be very careful with my movement. I'm going to hold perfectly up because in the second phase, he's going to bounce back and forth. And if I hold perfectly up, he'll just bounce vertically, and it's much easier to hit him.
Ready to go? Take that. Take that. Take that.
All right, he attacked me, which is unlucky. If he doesn't attack you, you can save a couple seconds here. Really good though. Like a 23 or something.
Alright.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Now we're going to probably my favorite worlds next.
Yeah. This next level is the longest level in the game. Also has 2 of the scariest jumps in the game. Well, 3, I guess, because one of them you have to do twice.
Ready to go?
So right when I grab this carrot here, you'll see the nice smooth 60 FPS up here. It's very crisp for like 2 seconds.
Then you turn around.
Then you turn around and the whole level loads in and it goes back to 25. Okay, that's one of the scary jumps. That one's just scary in terms of just the amount of distance you have to clear. It's the one that's coming up next that I'm scared about. This one. So I have to bounce off of an enemy to reset my jumps midair. Let's see, where is one? Right, I'm gonna go for this guy here. All right, now I have to do that again to get to the end of the level. Really scared I was gonna die there. All right, then I have to land on this end platform without hitting this enemy.
All right.
Nice.
Good level.
That was a good level. Very happy to get that one out of the way. This is another similar-ish aesthetic level.
Ready to go?
Shouts to Crab Rave. This guy here is having a good time. So recently there was like a minor strat update in this level. I don't know, it was maybe like a month or so ago. It's just a tiny movement optimization I'll point out when I get there. Also, shout outs to Games right there. Who loves Games? Alright, so the small optimization is using that triangle there again. I'm gonna miss this jump.
Ooh.
That's fine. You can back that up. Right, now, this is the one I don't wanna miss. Alright, get ready to party, everyone. Here we go. LSD mode.
And it's over.
Yeah, it's the only time you'll see that. All right, so this next boss has three different things he can transform into. One is really, really bad, one is okay, and one is really good. And it's random which one he chooses, so.
Ready to go?
And we got the really good one. Okay, this could be good. I could kill him. If I play this right, I will be able to kill this guy before he transforms back. Maybe not if I do that. One or two hits away.
Yeah.
I missed the one hit. That's what really set me back. I'll just kill him right there.
There you go. Still good.
Yeah, it still wasn't that bad.
All right.
I probably actually was on record pace up until that boss fight. Now I'm definitely not.
Hey, you can relax. It's all good.
Yeah. It's probably still possible to get it, but, you know, I won't know until later. Because I'll have to go back and retime this. Right, this is the last platforming level in the game and has the best music in the game. It's one of the more fun levels, so here we go. Collecting a bunch of weapons here. I'm gonna use all of these weapons on the next boss, even though there are two bosses left.
Yeah, the last two levels are bosses. So breaking from the trend, 2-2-4-2 were both the dungeon crawlers, but 6-2 is a boss.
So this next boss, I want to lure him into repeatedly attacking me, because if he's not attacking me, that means he's trying to go to one of these pedestals, and if he's on the pedestal, he becomes invulnerable for like 20 seconds and spawns a bunch of enemies. So we don't want that to happen, so here we go. Please attack me.
Oh,
this is good. I can actually hit him. Wow, this is... Okay, I should kill him here.
There you go.
Goodness gracious. That was pretty bad. I had the Roman candle. I just missed him.
Good enough.
Yeah, that's all right. He didn't go to the pedestal, which would still have been worse than what just happened there. Alright, and now we have the final boss. This guy is actually extremely difficult. I'm gonna restart to get a bomb, and then I'm gonna stand still to lure him to attack me so I can get a couple free hits. And then,
ready to go?
It's really gonna happen.
He's got three phases, and Joe's gonna try and manipulate his movement to get better hits. Phase one is the nipple lasers and walking around.
So he kind of mirrors your movement, so I'm doing circles in the air above him, but sometimes like that, he just runs away. This is a good loop I haven't stuck in here. Okay, that's phase one. Now he's the little tank guy. This guy's much easier to hit than the big guy.
And time's gonna be coming up at clear.
Yeah, when the clear text pops up at the end of this boss. One more hit should switch him into phase three. Nice, I got the kill in the midair there. All right, get ready on time. Right. Time.
Very nice.
Yeah, that was a pretty good run, actually. I got most of the bosses went really well, especially the third one, which is the one that is always horrible. I think the real time record's like 1920, so.
Prepare yourself, Robert. Now my minions are really ready for you.
Any shout outs?
Hold on, gotta wait for this.
Oh. You ain't done yet.
Great sound effect there. So I do want to give a couple shout outs. Shout outs to Squid, who's here. He's the person who got me into running this game. He's the person I saw run it. I want to give a shout out to Brian Nash, who had the original run of this game on SDA in like 2012. A shout out to Arada, who had the record in this game for like 3 or 4 years. Shout outs to Javelin, who has had the record in this game and has found a bunch of stuff. And then a shout out to Amra, who just came out of nowhere like a couple months ago and really tore the scene up. And then I'm gonna leave you guys with this. So when you beat the game, you unlock extra mode, which is the levels are the same, but the carrots and the exit pods are moved. And then you also unlock super mode. Super mode is exactly the same as the normal game, except it has a magical button called L1, and it does this. So here's your normal movement speed. If you just hold down L1, you just go insanely fast here. You also get 5 jumps. So controlling this is really fun. It's also insanely difficult. The record for playing the game in this mode is like half of the record in the for a full game. But yeah, that's all I think I have. Thanks to Kane for commentating. And thanks again for watching. If you want to learn this game, we do have a Discord. You can go to the leaderboards and join the Discord for this game and its sequel, which is very similar, and the very off-brand Robot Mondu. So if you want to run any of those games, go to the leaderboards and join the Discord. Thanks for watching, and stick around for Kuru Kuru, because that game is awesome.
Let's hear it again for Joestar and that awesome jump and flash run. This is Awesome Games Done Quick 2020. Coming up next, we've got Kudu 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 In with Mohawk. Stick around for that one. But in the meantime, let's jump back into some of y'all's donations, shall we? We have $15 from David M89. I've missed out on a lot of AGDQ because I've been busy, but I'm glad I didn't miss the smooth jumping flash run. Can't wait to see the rest of the runs today. $30 from Zekier210. First time attending a GDQ. Shout outs to all the speed friends I've met, and here's to another 10 years. $25 from Mickey Lady. To my mom and anyone else battling cancer, you got this and we've got you. This AGDQ is particularly meaningful given your recent diagnosis, and the outpouring of support from our community has been humbling and inspiring. Let's kick cancer's butt. $30 from Tyronius Maximus. Hello, everyone. I've been watching the past few years, and I'm finally able to donate to this amazing cause. Let's all work together to end cancer. Honk! $20 from Jono145. Love to see runners break apart so many great games, and for such a good cause. Happy 10 years, GDQ. Let's get Link's Awakening on the schedule. That is, of course, the Link's Awakening on the Switch bonus game incentive, which is currently at a bit under 75,800 of 400,000. A ways to go. Thankfully, we still got a good amount of time to see that one met, but that's definitely one we do not want to miss. Speaking of which, a little bit of an update on those I keep saying it that way. Goodness, I know better. I took Japanese for 2 years, I swear. Katana Zero incentives. The psychotherapy super hidden boss is sitting at a bit under 4,000 left on that one. The upgrade to hard mode is at a bit over 7,000, and the one nearest and dearest to me, Pet the Cat, still needs a little bit more than 24,000 to go on that one. But how could you not want to pet the cat? I mean, I haven't even met this cat yet, and I already love it to bits. Sorry, I was thinking about petting cats for a moment there. We have $10 from Grimmers. Thank you to everyone who helps to put on this event. Good luck to all the remaining runners, and let's kick cancer's butt. $100 from the cat says, moo. My great aunt is a 2-time cancer survivor, so I felt it was only right for me to donate for this cause. Thank you to everyone at GDQ, and here's to hoping we can break SGDQ 2019's donation record of over 3 million. $50 from Crazy Diamond. In honor of Neil Peart, a legend and inspiration, he was somebody's hero. Let's shine on and beat cancer. We have $450 from Le French Restream. Says, one last donation from Le French Restream for Le Coin, a French joke, on Kudu Kudu Kududine. Go Mohawk. Another awesome event. GG, everyone. $10 from J150. Shout out to the, like, 3 people in the audience. Give us a honk or orb or whatever to prove that you're still alive. No! Hope you all heard that. And I can promise you we're at least in double digits out there. I can't give you an exact count because I need to go to my optometrist, but I see multiple people, I promise. Would I lie to you? Nah. $20 from Tobin19. Figured I would chip in what I could for a great late night stream. Loving the runs. Greetings from Japan. $50 from Cabs. Good morning from the UK. Good morning, Cabs. How are you today? All right, friends, we're going to toss it to a Twitch ad real quick, but don't worry, we'll see you again real soon. patience pays off. We have returned. We've got $25 from Fane of Fife. Did I hear Link's Awakening? Gotta see that. Yes, you do. Link's Awakening, I'm proud to say, has passed 76,000. Has been continuously moving up since I sat down, and I am loving how it just keeps on rolling. Let's keep that going, my friends. $100 from No Name. Love GDQ. Thank you to everyone. Awesome job to the people behind the scenes. $176.59 from, I'm sorry if I butchered this a little bit, Brozufi. Finally able to give money after all those years of watching GDQ. Thank you all. Going to Aqua for the Kingdom Hearts run. Those of you very invested in which characters played in that Birth by Sleep run, right now Aqua is in fact in the lead at a bit over 3,100, with Terra trailing behind at a hair under 2,700. So if for whatever reason you would like Terra, or even Ventus, who is not doing so hot. So if you really want Ventus, get your friends together and get some dollars thrown at that lad, because he's trailing behind. $20 from Jono145. Love to see runners break apart so many great games and for such a good cause. Happy 10 years, GDQ. Let's get Link's Awakening on the schedule. $100 from Ace Barredo. Prizes? Yeah, we got those. We got lots of those, in fact. We've got all sorts of things. We have a plush of Bonk the Caveman from the earlier Bonk's Adventure run. We got an entire Perler scene from Contra, a Perler scene from Metroid. We've also got the Mac Daddy of them all. We've got the Heroic Replica's custom replica Master Sword and Hylian Shield. All sorts of great things. All you gotta do is donate, and if you hit those cumulative totals, you are automatically entered. See more about the prize we got available at gamesonquick.com/tracker. $100 from Blot Blot. No sleep till Super Metroid. You are a braver soul than I. But more power to you. $101 from Sully90. I lost my dad to cancer this last year in May after his 30-year long off and on battle. Here's hoping this donation can help prevent another from losing a loved one. He wasn't a gamer, but the Soul Series is my favorite, so I wanted to donate during it in his name. Here's to you, Sully. Souls was a little bit earlier, but I felt that one still needed to be shared. We've got $100 from Mosh. My mother lost the battle against cancer earlier this year. Here's to a future where no one will have to face that battle, and prevention is key. Friendly reminder to submit your receipts to your employer, as they typically match your donations and sometimes more. Good luck to all the runners. We have $500 from Haste. Says, my father was recently diagnosed with two type 4 cancers, and I'd like to someday be at a place where no one has to feel that. Well, Haste, we absolutely wish all the best to your father in fighting that. And we agree wholeheartedly. We would love the future to be a place where nobody has to feel that. And the PCF is absolutely working toward that with their focus on cancer prevention and early detection. 100 dollars from True Geek. Love watching GDQ every time it comes around and always have to donate to these amazing charities. Thanks to everyone in front of and behind the camera that make this whole event possible. Well, True Geek, don't forget about all you all out there watching and donating. This would not be possible without all of you as well, and from the bottom of our hearts, we thank you. We truly do. $100 from friend Juke. Keep up the good work. Let's beat SGDQ 2019. Money towards bonus any percent goose game. Honk! And any percent untitled goose game, that bonus run is currently sitting at a little bit under 24,000 of the 150,000. That's going to be later on today. So if you want a little bit more goose in your life, not real geese, obviously, but I mean a little bit more of this delightful video game goose in your life, then you know what you have to do, my friends. All right, we have $10.10 from No Name. In honor of it being the 10-year anniversary of the awesomeness that is AGDQ, let's start a $10.10 train and get that total past the $3 million mark. Here's my 10-10. I like the way you're thinking, No Name. Can we do that? You think we can get a $10.10 train started here, even though it's this late? I say we can. The day's only started. Let's make this train as long as we can. $20 from Talkie Pup, who says, it's video games. I can't argue with that. $100 from Blank186, a comment, heart. Yeah. I don't have too much to add to that one either. $25 from Big Jeb, who says, hey, GDQ, donating in honor of my grandmother who passed from cancer a little over a year ago. Ha ha ha. $250 from Corumdum Core. More games means more GDQ means more money going to prevent cancer. You know, that's mathematics I can get behind right there. $50 from Nate166. I've been watching for many years and haven't always been able to donate. Today I work at a cancer research hospital and I'm able to give more than ever. Thank you for being a consistent source of inspiration and love. And thank you for all your work, both at the hospital and here with your generosity, Nate. Thank you so much. We have $25 from Alex209. I've been watching GDQs for the past 5 years or so, and every year just blows me away with what this community can do. But I've never decided to donate until now. This AGDQ means a lot to me because last month my little brother was diagnosed with Erwing's sarcoma, a rare bone cancer. Him and I share a love for video games, so seeing all this money raised is truly amazing. I don't want anyone to have to suffer this terrible disease after seeing my brother fight it for the past month. On the bright side, he's been homebound, so he's playing all the video games he wants. Thank you, AGDQ and Prevent Cancer Foundation, for all you do. Let's kick cancer's butt. Alex, we absolutely wish your brother all the best in fighting Erwing's sarcoma, and thank you so much for your generosity. Did you hear that, everybody? Did you hear that? I think I hear a trainer rolling because we have $10.10 from Tetriel. Did I hear a $10.10 train? Yes. Yes, you did. And we have $10.10 from Non-Toast. Choo-choo! Put this toward the announcer's choice. My choice is Katana Zero, Pet the Cat. Why do I keep saying Katana instead of Katana? Goodness gracious. We have $20.20 from Mutt. 10-10, but it's 2020. I feel like a fool now, but you know what? We roll with what we get. $10.10 from Selroth, joining in for the 10-10 train. Thanks a lot, GDQ, for these events. They are the best moments of my year. $10.10 from Cacodemum. Donation train a go-go. Greetings from Australia. And we have $100.10 from Havo. Choo-choo! $25 from X Kyle NL, my $10.10, and some more. Keep up the good work, and thanks to all the runners, volunteers, and staff.